सब्सक्राइब करें ऑडियो इक्वल चैनल को और उस बेल बटन को दबाइए नोटिफिकेशन के लिए। Hi guys, welcome to Auto Geek World. I am here at Radar Motors, Uppal. So let's get inside and see what's there for us. So this is the all new Aprilia SR160. So we are going to ride it. Let's get riding. If you ask the meaning of the phrase pocket rocket, you would definitely say it's the Duke 390. But what's the pocket rocket in the scooters? Let's get to know. So the most loved Aprilia in India, the SR150 gets a BS6 update and now called the SR160. Despite being the first in the segment scooter to get a 160cc engine, there are little compromises, but of course, there's very little to complain about this CVT machine. First, let's talk about the design. There are no major changes at all, except for the SR160 sticker. But it gets a new red as well as black color options for the standard variant. Now I really like the red color, it is quite punchy. It also gets carbon fiber and a race variant. Getting into the instrument cluster, the display is a semi-digital one which has been updated right before the BS6 norms came into play. So you get an analog speedo and a digital trip meter, fuel gauge, clock and odometer with the ABS indicator is present in there. The headlamp is the same conventional unit illuminating the scooter from the day it has been launched. Well, the same in the case of tail lamp, and it really misses on LED which other scooters are offering at even lower prices. And in addition, you get Bluetooth connectivity but at additional cost. While the overall design and body dynamics remains exactly the same, well, talking about the new updates on the engine that it got. The Aprilia SR160 gets a fuel-injected air-cooled motor with a slightly bump on the cc with 160cc displacement, which can produce 11 PS of power, that means 0.6 PS more than the previous one, and the torque remains the same as such of 11.6 Nm. Also getting the catalytic converter to obey BS6 norms, while the rest of the things look same as before. And if we talk about the performance of the scooter, in spite of the slight bump, the engine has the same characteristics as of the before. Give it the throttle, you will see the scooter feels like a normal scooter and there is no rush. You must give up to overtake at lower speed, but get into the speeds above 30 and you will notice the power coming with excellent mid-range performance. Besides this, you will feel like home at higher speeds like 80 to 90 and ease. The best thing is you will not notice any sorts of vibration even at those speeds and it is smooth as butter. While the exhaust note doesn't seem to be new, it's just the old scream. Even with the pillion, there is no drop in performance in the mid-range and you will have fun for long distance travels. The initial pickup remains calm and gains aggressiveness in the mid-range, which is quite strong, and so as the top end. The engine does justify the sport tag it carries. Now, the most important aspect of this scooter, the handling. The SR160 disappointed me while taking quick turns in traffic, which I literally meant to say that it's not that crisp in handling and is slightly difficult to ride in tight spaces and for long runs. I have noticed a hesitation while flickering around while taking sudden turns, but wait, there is a good point in this too. That is, it can do pretty well when you are on the highway and even at long run to ground corners. It's a super stable and confident in corners at higher revs. The ride quality is excellent on the open stretch even with the pillion. The scooter is quite stable at very high speeds. At low speeds, except the power lag, the handling is good but not the best. The stiffer thing in the video, the suspension setup. which is same as before, is tuned to be a little smoother at front, while the rear suspension is a preload adjustable monoshock, which we got from the discontinued BS4 variant, but it's on the stiffer side even now. So if you try to get into wildest off-roads, if you can, then you must be ready for the butt pain. It's better the way it's ridden on the bad city roads and streets, and however, it's actually offering the best stability on the highway. Besides high speed cornering with the stiffer suspension, there's nothing to complain about. You will sweep through the corners like anything. Whereas the seat is adjustable for the rider, but it wouldn't be sufficient for the pillion if the rider is healthy like me, and the grab rail isn't placed well to hold on for the pillion too. The floorboard is the same as before. It could have been wider this time for more space, as it feels a little bit congested. But yeah, as the Aprilias are meant to do sports scooters, it satisfies the sacrifice in the space, as they are concentrated on the sporty ergonomics, which ultimately took over a lot of pillion seat space to look sporty and edgy. Now on the brakes. At front, it gets a 220mm disc and a 140mm drum at rear, which are under the control of single channel ABS, which works absolutely well and precisely. I found this to be one of the best in these scooters. But as always, single channel ABS may not do well at all the times because of the rear drum brake, which locks up and gives a lot of chances to skid, and the only confidence you get is from the front disc. It could be better if it gets that bite which is missing because of the drum brake, and I would expect a disc at rear at least for the money that I'm paying for. Apart from that, overall braking is quite impressive compared to the BS4 model. We tested the brakes at 80 km/h and slammed over the levers like anything. It took around a stopping distance of 15 meters along with the pillion on. And the biggest advantage on this scooter is its tires. With the 14-inch alloys along with 120 section tires, it's a great combo for driving on any terrain, as it just doesn't let feel any bad roads, which no other scooter could offer to do so. And the grip that the tires offer is exceptional, which gives you confidence on hard braking. The tires are very much sticky to the ground. Finally, the pricing. The standard SR160 will cost you around 1.03 lakhs ex-showroom and 1.24 lakhs on-road Hyderabad, while the carbon fiber variant will cost you more at 1.27 lakhs and add another 4000 at 1.31 lakhs for the race edition. At this price, you are getting a performance machine that is also a scooter. So if you are looking for a easy-going sports machine, then the Aprilia is absolutely correct for you. Don't expect something from a regular scooter like more space and better suspension, but what you get in return is more thrill. So if you like our content, please do subscribe to our channel and press the bell icon so that whenever we post a video, you will be notified at first.